Hi, welcome back to Shades of Radiology. Today I'm going to discuss a topic which looks always complex. A lot of us feel confused how to differentiate this mosaic attenuation, what is mosaic attenuation, what is GGO, what is mosaic perfusion and all. I'll try to simplify it with three slides about this mosaic attenuation in the lungs. So let us see what it is. So once you take a CT chest of the patient, look at the lung attenuation in the entire lung. If the attenuation of the lung is completely normal and it's uniform in the all areas of lung, then both are happy, even the patient and we will be happy as the lung looks normal. So what if there is increased areas of attenuation? Once there is an increased area of attenuation in the lung fields, look at the vessel density in the lucent areas and also areas of increased attenuation. Suppose if the vessel density is same in both the lucent areas and in the increased areas of lung attenuation, then we call it as groundless opacity. So here is the example of classic COVID infection which we are regularly seeing. That is a classic example of groundless opacity. Suppose if the vessel density is reduced in the areas of lucent lung, that is if you see a lucent area of lung here and this is the increased attenuated lung, if you see a reduced vessel density in comparison of both areas, then we call it as mosaic perfusion. So don't confuse about this groundless opacity and mosaic perfusion. Now it's clear. So once these reduced areas of reduced number of the vessels in the lucent lung, we call it as mosaic perfusion. And what are the causes of mosaic perfusion? That is what we need to give in the report or we need to evaluate in a patient. So the mosaic perfusion could be due to air trapping, due to airway disease or a vascular cause leading to this appearance. So let us see how to differentiate them. So this is a normal lung which I have illustrated with normal vascular markings in the entire lung. And here in the second image, if you see, there are few increased areas of attenuation in the lung. And if you see, the vessel density is almost same in both lucent areas as well as areas of increased attenuation. So what is it? It is a groundless opacity. You are seeing the vessels through an opacified or increased attenuated lung. We call it as groundless attenuation or groundless opacity. So this is a groundless opacification areas like typically seen in COVID-19. And see, this is the case of mosaic perfusion. If you see, the vessels in the lucent areas of the lung are showing decreased density. If you see the decreased number of vessels in the lucent areas, then it is mosaic perfusion. So with this image, you should be able to clearly differentiate what is GGO and what is mosaic perfusion. So how to go with mosaic perfusion? And this mosaic perfusion is mainly due to vascular oligemia and vasoconstriction, which can happen in both causes, that is the vascular cause as well as in the causes of air trapping. So what are the clues on imaging that can help in narrowing the differential diagnosis, or which features will direct towards air trapping and which features will direct towards the vascular cause? If you see the presence of bronchial wall thickening, bronchiectasis, which is patchy and lobular involvement, think of air trapping, that is due to the airway disease. Suppose if it is due to vascular cause, look at the dilated main pulmonary artery, look at the main pulmonary artery ratio to aorta. It will be more than the diameter of aorta. Enlarged segmental pulmonary arteries, bronchial artery hypertrophy. If you do the contrast, you can see this very well, that is the bronchial arteries are hypertrophied, or segmental arteries are also, segmental pulmonary arteries are also enlarged. And usually this is confluent and usually peripheral in location of the lung field. So this is how we differentiate the causes of mosaic perfusion and the imaging clues which help us in differentiating the air trapping and vascular cause of mosaic perfusion. And one important thing which we need to keep in mind to confirm the diagnosis of air trapping, we do expiratory CT scans. Suppose if you do an expiratory CT scan in a normal lung, in the patient, in a normal individual without any lung disease, due to expiratory scan, there will be uniform increase in attenuation of the lung. if the patient is having an airway disease due to air trapping, what exactly happens is the lucent areas of the lung do not show any increased attenuation. It appears more black due to adjacent increase in attenuation of the normal lung. So hope you understand. Please be clear. In a patient with an airway disease having areas of air trapping, if you do an expiratory CT scan, the lucent areas will remain same, whereas the normal lung shows increased attenuation. That is, the lucent areas appear more darker because of surrounding lung parenchyma showing increased attenuation. So this is how we differentiate the air trapping from a vascular cause, one of the other method which to differentiate or to confirm the air trapping, that is the expiratory CT scan. So this is one excellent journal published in RSNA. You can go back and see the mosaic attenuation, etiology, methods of differentiation, and what are the pitfalls, which is very important. The pitfalls are very important. Sometimes the mosaic attenuation is seen in normal individuals, how to differentiate them, and all those things. Thank you all.